Hello, Assalamu alaikum. My name is Tahir Naeem. We are studying e-commerce. So far we have got 10 lectures in today's 11th lecture. Topic of our today's lecture is HTML2 or continuation of from the previous lecture. This is outline for today's lecture. First of all, we will look into HTML documents. Then we will look into doc type declaration. Then we will look at HTML headings. Then we will discuss headings tag. Then we will look at paragraph tags. Then we will look at HTML links. Then we will look at HTML images. Then we will look at how to view source code. Then we will look at HTML tags. Then we will discuss nested HTML elements. Then we will explain the code, and then we will discuss end tag. Then we will discuss empty HTML and case sensitivity and HTML tag reference. We will discuss HTML documents. All HTML document must start with a document type declaration, doc type HTML. The HTML document itself begin with HTML and ends with /HTML. The visible part of HTML document is between body and /body. Just look at the example here. Is I have discussed previously that every document must start with doc type HTML. Then we will start with HTML. Then the body will start here. I have given heading 1, my first heading, and I close heading. Then my first paragraph. Then I close paragraph. Body HTML. Doc type declaration. Doc type declaration represents the document type and help browser to display web pages correctly. It must only appears once at top of the page before any HTML tags. The doc type declaration is not case sensitive. The doc type declaration for HTML file is doc type HTML, as I have mentioned earlier. HTML heading. HTML headings are defined with heading 1 to heading 6 tags. H1 defines the most important heading, H6 defines the least important heading. I am giving you example here, doc type HTML, then I will write HTML, then I will write a body, then heading, this is the heading 1, this is H2, this is heading 2. This is heading 3, this is heading 4, this is heading 5, this is heading 6, body and HTML. As I have read in this program, I have emphasized the 6 headings of starting from 1 up to 6, and I have started H1, then close the heading 1, then start the heading 2. Let's look at how it will look in the browser. This is the program I have written in my notepad and saved.html, and I have run in the web browser. Look at this. This is heading 1. It is the biggest heading. While this is heading 2, this is heading 3, this is heading 4, this is heading 5, this is heading 6. This is the paragraph. HTML paragraph are defined with p tag. This is the example I have given. This p, it starts from p, and /p, it ends with /p, and look at this result. This is the paragraph, and then it will automatically, if I start another paragraph, then it will move to the another line. This is another paragraph. Look at the results which I have given this on the side screen. HTML links. HTML links are defined with a tag. The link destination is specified in href attribute. Attributes are used to provide additional information about HTML element. I have given an example. Look at this. is a href. This is attribute, and I have given the address https://w.cus.edu.pk:// and this is the link. This will be displayed while when I click on this, it will automatically redirect me towards this address here. Look at the result. This is the link which is displayed, and when I click on this is the link, then it will automatically redirect me to www.cus.edu.pk. HTML images. HTML images are defined with img tag. The source file src alternative text alt width and height are provided as attributes. I'm giving you an example here. Look at this img source. This is source src stand for source. Here I'm giving you this is the address of the from where image is taken, and alternative source, if it's not available, then it's the alternative source from image is picked up, and this is width and this is height. So it we can also specify how what should be the height of this image, and what should what can be the width of the image. View source code. Have you ever seen a web page and wonder, hey, how did they do it? How we can view HTML source code? Right click in the HTML page and select view page source in Chrome, or view source in Edge or similar in other browser. This will open a window containing the HTML source code of the page. Inspect an HTML element. Right click on an element or blank area and choose inspect or inspect element to see what elements are made up. You will see both HTML and CSS. You can also edit HTML or CSS on the fly, or elements or style panel that opens. HTML tags. All elements in it is defined by a start tag, some contents and end tag. Tag names, contents goes here, and here I will close this tag. And HTML elements is everything from the start tag to the end tag. H1, this is my first heading /H1. This is paragraph tag P, my first paragraph /P. Some HTML elements have no contents, like the break elements. These elements are called empty elements. Empty elements do not have tag and tag. And break means that the line is broken and next line is started. Nested HTML elements. HTML elements can be nested. That means that it can contain other elements. All HTML documents consist of nested HTML elements. The following example contains 4 HTML elements. HTML body H1B. This is the example here I am using. This is the HTML tag, this is the body tag, and there it's nested inside. The H1 is nested H1, and this P is nested inside, and then we close the body and then we close the HTML tag. This is my first heading. This is the end result of explanation. The HTML elements is the root element that defines the whole HTML document. It is start tag HTML and end tag /HTML. Then is inside the HTML element there is a body element. The body elements define the document body. It is start tag body and end tag /body. Then inside the body elements there is two other elements H1 and P. The H1 elements define a heading. It is start tag H1 and end tag /H1. The P elements define a paragraph. It is start tag P and end tag /P. End tag. Some HTML elements will display correctly if even you forget the end tag. However, we can never rely on this. Unexpected result and errors may occur if you forget the end tag.
Here I am giving example that this paragraph P I have given and there is no end tag, as you can see here, and there I am giving up another paragraph and we we don't mention slash P, and it is giving us a correct result, but sometimes error occurs. HTML elements. Empty HTML elements with no contents are called empty elements. The break tag defines a line break is an empty element without a closing tag. This is the example here. I'm here inserting a break paragraph with a line break slash P. Here it means that this is a, and here the line will automatically, it will the cursor will move to next line, it will break from here paragraph with this line break, and here is the result. This is a, and here it breaks and comes to next line paragraph with a line break. Case sensitivity. HTML tags are not case sensitive. Capital P means the same as lowercase p. The HTML standard does not require lowercase tags. HTML tag reference, as we have discussed previously, the HTML tag defines the root of an HTML document, while the body defines the document body, while the H1 to H6 define the HTML heading. These are the materials I have taken, I have prepared my lecture from. Queries regarding Moodle lecture, feel free to email me. Thank you. Love this.